My name is Ning Kang from SAS Institute. In this video, I'm going to give two examples to show how you can use the ICA procedure to perform independent component analysis. Independent component analysis, or ICA, is a statistical technique for revealing the hidden factors of data. The ICA model assumes that the observed data variables are linear mixtures of some unknown latent variables, and the mixing process is unknown. The latent variables are assumed to be non-Gaussian and statistically independent. These latent variables are called the independent component of the observed data. Independent components can be estimated using independent component analysis. You can use the ICA procedure to perform independent component analysis. This procedure is available starting in SAS Visual Statistics 8.3 in SAS Viya. The first example uses the PROC ICA to perform independent component analysis on simulated time signal data. The figure on the right shows the three source signals, S1, S2, and S3. The horizontal axis displays the time index, and the vertical axis displays the amplitude of the signal. The figure on the left shows the observed signals, X1, X2, and X3. Which are linear mixtures of the three source signals. The purpose of this example is to show how to use PROC ICA to estimate the source signals only from the observed signals. The observed data contain four variables, the time index variable T and three amplitude variables X1, X2, and X3. The amplitude values at each time index constitute an observation. There are 200 observations in the data. The signal dataset is named Signals 1. Because PROC ICA is a SAS Viya procedure, the dataset is loaded into the cache session, MyCache. Here, we specified n equals to 3, which tells PROC ICA to compute three independent components. The seed values for pseudo-random number generation, which is used to initialize the demixing matrix. Three variables, X1, X2, and X3, are specified in the var statement for the analysis. The output statement stores the computed independent components in the output data table named scores1 and names the components C1, C2, and C3. The copy var equals option transfers the time index variable T from the input data table to the output data table. By default, PROC ICA centers and scales the input data. Now, let's look at the plots of the computed independent components C1, C2, and C3. In the figure on the left, the plots are generated by using the scores1 output data table and PROC SG render. In each plot, the horizontal axis displays the time index, and the vertical axis displays the value of a computed independent component. The figure on the right shows the original source signals S1, S2, and S3. Comparing the two figures, you can see that the original source signals are accurately estimated by the computed independent components up to multiplicative signed scalars. Also, notice that the order of the computed independent components does not match the order of the source signals. For example, the source signals S1 is estimated by the independent component C3, not C1. This example demonstrates the ambiguities of the ICA model, where the magnitudes and the order of the computed independent components cannot be determined. The second example uses the PROC ICA to perform independent component analysis on microeconomic data. The data that this example uses are from the SAS Help dataset CITIMA, which provides city-based monthly microeconomic indicators from January 1980 to January 1992. The purpose of this example is to show how to use PROC ICA to explore whether independent component analysis can reveal the underlying structures of microeconomic data. Such hidden factors could include news, major events, and unexplained noise. This table displays variable information in the CITIMA dataset, which shows there are 19 variables. The first one is the data variable, which gives the data of observation. The remaining 18 variables are the monthly indicators, including energy consumption number, gasoline retail price, stock price indices, unemployment rate, produce price index, retail sales numbers, and so on. Here, each of the 18 monthly indicators is plotted as a time series plot, which is generated by the CityMon dataset and the PROC SD render. In each plot, the horizontal axis displays the date of observation, and the vertical axis displays the value of the monthly indicator. The CityMon dataset is loaded into the CAS session, MyCAS. All 18 variables of the monthly indicators are specified in the var statement for the analysis. Here, we do not use the n equal option, as we do in the first example, to explicitly specify the number of independent components to compute, because by default, the number of independent components to compute is the number of variables specified in the var statement. So the number of independent components to compute in this case is 18. If you are not sure how to choose the number of independent components to compute for your analysis, using the default value for the n equal option is a good way to start. The output statement stores the computed independent components in the output data table named scores2 and names the components C1, C2 through C18. The copy var equal option transfers a data variable from the input data table to the output data table. Now, let's look at the plots of the computed independent components C1, C2 through C18. The 18 plots are generated by using the scores2 output data table and the PROC SD render. In each plot, the horizontal axis displays the date of observation, and the vertical axis displays the value of a computed independent component. The independent components shown here can be seen as very distinct thrust signals that constitute the underlying structure of the microeconomic data. The infrequent but large and abrupt changes depict the impact of the news or major events on the monthly indicators. These events are responsible for the major shifts in the indicators. The frequent but smaller fluctuations contribute much less to the overall levels of the monthly indicators. Let's take a look at the three circles marked in the plots. The red circle indicates a large and sudden bump in 1987 in the independent component C17. This clearly is caused by the stock market crash that year. The blue circle indicates a large and sudden spike in 1990 in the independent component C11, which is most likely to reflect the impact of the Gulf War that year. The green circle, however, shows that component C6 is most likely to be a noise factor in the data. For other computed independent components, the large and sudden changes in certain years can have different interpretations, depending on the major events of that year. This video has been a brief introduction to independent component analysis, which is a method of finding underlying factors or independent components from the observed data. You can use the ICA procedure to perform independent component analysis in many different applications, including signal processing and econometrics. PROC ICA is available in SAS Visual Statistics 8.3 in SAS Viya. For more information, you can check out the SAS Global Forum 2019 paper Independent Component Analysis Using the ICA Procedure. Thank you for watching.